Just let me know when to start the playing and I'll...
Okay, cool. All right, so we're playing... we're playing with Unleash Hell expansion of Joan of Arc, playing the Devil in Avignon scenario. It's a bit of a beast. It took a while to set up, but these are all the armies. So the Devil, which Andrew's going to be playing, and his units. We've got the Papal Army, which I'm playing, which are here, so the Holy Army. And then I've got Italian reinforcements and quite a few of those, as well as the Pope Clement the VI and Archangel Gabriel. So the whole point of the scenario is the evil player, the Devil player, is trying to find the Pope and destroy him to win the scenario. And I'm just basically trying to stop that from happening or try and destroy the Devil, which could seem quite hard. Okay, so it's all set up. We've got some Sky Hexes as well. I've just currently placed my tokens into the buildings. And one of those is the Pope. Three are decoys. And now I need to set up my Papal Army by putting those into the buildings for setup. So it says here, there must be at least one unit in each of the four buildings on the board. Okay, the other Papal Army units and their rally point are placed in the village area. So as long as I'm in the stone area, which is the village area, I'm fine. I've just got to make sure I put at least one unit in each. So these are all my units. I do have a culverin. That's awesome. Okay, I do have a culverin. So I'm going to place my culverin. Excuse me. Over here. Now we want some decent. The halberdiers are my best retaliation force, so let's make sure we keep one with them. I want the executioner and the inquisitor together. Oh, right, okay. So Jean de Mers, just to let you know, Andrew, is all about giving the building more resistance. So, oh wow, okay. So he is going into the church. Jean de Meur is going into the church. That's definitely true. Philippe de Vitré is going to head over to the large house on the left with the yellow top. The Inquisitor and the Executioner are going to go to the to an area over here. The forget that. I'm going to put those into there, so I'm controlling that area straight off the bat. These will go down into the kind of cloister. I need to put my archers where they can shoot. So the archers are going to go into the area containing the small house. Hang on a minute, let me think. So I've got one in each of those buildings. I need to put something in that building. So foot knights, and then I'm going to put a halberdiers up in the large house here and some halberdiers in the church as well. So just to show you, just to talk through it, Andrew, we got bowmen, two bowmen here in this bottom section here. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah, so that's all. Let me just get that set up.
Yep, no problem. So we're doing this, we're playing this remotely.
So the bowmen are set up, yeah.
Okay, in this house, so in the house itself is just one unit of foot knights.
Okay.
Then we move across to the ruins.
Yeah.
And the executioner and the inquisitor in there.
Okay.
Then we go
all the the strategic points straight away. It makes sense.
Pretty much. I've left them well, but yeah, we'll deal with that. On the shrine, we've got the culverine and a unit of halberdiers.
Yes.
In the church, I've got gendarmes.
Okay.
The civilian guy, and a unit of halberdiers.
Unit of halberdiers, okay.
In the house on the left hand side, so my yellow topped house,
sure,
surrounded by walls, is Philip de Vitré and another unit of halberdiers.
Okay.
And finally, in the top house, is a unit of foot knights.
Awesome, good, and that correlates with everything being deployed.
And now I need to place my. And now I need to just place my my rally point into one of the areas, which will be the church area.
Okay.
Okay. So that's me set up. So it's now over to you.
Okay. So I am going to the Unholy Army, and there's five deployment areas on the map where I can put things. The first thing I need to decide is where I'm going to put my devil and where I'm going to potentially destroy the trees that are already there. So I have a sneaky suspicion.
Yeah.
That you're in one of the big houses with the Pope, and you're trying to create a bit of a rails with the. Sure. So I think what I'm going to try and do is call you out quite early. So I'm going to place the devil on the area with the two trees over here.
I can't.
Two trees are going to come up.
Can you show me on your screen?
And the devil is going to go there.
Okay. The one that's got the slightly different orientation.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay, so the two trees are destroyed and the devil goes on. Oh man, I love that miniature. It's not really a miniature, is it? But
yeah, it's huge. It's one of the masterpieces.
Sorry, just to interrupt, Andrew. I've just looked. When does Archangel Gabriel come on? I presume.
She gets triggered by the intrigue, by the papal army's intrigue.
Thank you very much. Okay, so here's my intrigue card. So four intrigue tokens, and then I can place on the free space area. Okay, cool.
So we're going to put a couple of wolves in the area next to the devil.
Yep.
And then we're going to get very...
Is that below them? Yeah, it's below them.
Yeah, there's two sets of wolves by the devil. And then right over here, near to the shrine...
Oh, the shrine, yep.
...area with the tree.
Yes.
We need to get quite aggressive because you've already got the shrine and you'll get some benefit if you retain that. So we are going to... put in all of the flying demons.
All of them?
Hope that you don't, you don't take them out too quickly.
Unfortunately, they've got immortal, haven't they?
They do indeed. That's why...
This is really annoying.
A bit of a strategy. And now we've got two more deployment areas left. So I'm just going to mix it up a little bit. So we're going to have one set of the Demonic Legion... up here, in this area.
One demonic? That was one demonic, so, wasn't it? Is that one demonic?
Yeah, one demonic and two wolves.
One demonic and two wolves.
And in the final area over here, we're going to have the...
That's also not... Oh no, I've got it slightly wrong. That's why. There we go. That's better. So that's the way it should be. And two walls.
That's me deployed. You want me to recap any of that?
Yeah, I'm going to need to recap all of it, I think.
Yeah, no problem.
So.
The devil is over here. Where the two trees were.
Yeah.
And in the area, the closest to it are the two wolves.
Yeah, got that.
Near the shrine where you have your culverine, I have my three flying demons next to the tree.
Yeah, got that.
Up in the top corner...
Yep.
I have one demonic legion and two wolves.
Yep, got that.
And in the other corner, in the left hand side, I have my last remaining wolves and the two demonic legion.
Okay, what about your heretics?
That is a really good point. I don't have the set of heretics to hand.
Have you got anything to...
So, to prevent holding that up and me going to find the set of heretics, my heretics now are the pikemen that I have.
Okay.
That was a bit nice and confusing, but it'll be fine.
And where are they going? Oh, hello, look at that. Going for my culverine early, are we?
Yeah, absolutely.
Is that a ballista?
So that's me set up.
Is that a ballista you've got down as a culverine?
Sorry?
Is that a ballista you've put down as a culverine?
Yeah, it might well be.
Okay. Okay, cool. So we're all set up. Just to point out, it does say 2 XP for each destroyed flying demon. So I presume that's if they are... I think that's if they ever get a kill result. So if I get a kill result on a dice, or if you roll the death symbol on the dice. Now, I know that they don't ever get destroyed permanently because they got immortal. But if they would ever would have normally, that's where how I get the XP.
Yeah, I think that's the correct interpretation.
Okay. Right. So I start the board. I start with an interrupt and a re-roll. And first player. You start with just a re-roll, obviously.
Yes.
Looking at the beginning of the second round, we get 3 units of my choice on one area of the edge board game and receive 1 activation order. And at third, oh god, at the beginning of the third round, I place all remaining units. Wow, okay. That's pretty massive. Right, okay, so let's go over to the board. I've shuffled them up, by the way. Have you got the Legends deck, yeah? Andrew?
Yeah, I've got this, the Myth Legend deck, I've got that.
Cool. Okay, so we've got 5 activations this turn. There's 2 5s, 2 4s, and 2 3s. So we've got our 5 activations there and our interrupt. Now we're going to see what War Council cards we've got. We've got gain 2 legend cards and a legend token and discard 1 card. That's the same, so we replace that. Swap legend tokens for activation, so that's not going to happen, or burn someone else's activation. So it's my choice first. I'm going to try and hamper you a little bit to start with. So I'm going to burn one of your command orders.
Okay, so that's fair enough. Well,
Five, so you take 4.
Okay, so I'm down to 4. Thank you very much. I did, swap this out, and I did, however, get some heretics.
Oh, you did? Oh, well done. God, he's awfully bad, this devil. Should I tell you why? Because of his command ability is crazy. All right.
He can basically command whoever he wants. It's like, come here and do
yeah, something. He really can. Cool. All right, sorry. Which War Council card do you want?
Oh, I'm going to destroy one of yours as well.
Oh, okay. So I take away one of my orders to go down to 4. Okay, so you've got no interrupt, so I've got a free ring.
You do.
So, Executioner. Right, it makes sense to try and start moving this group of people you've just put together away, which I think the Culverine's exceptionally good at. It's good at pushing units. So we're going to do that straight away, first of all, I think. Once per turn, if you spend 1, move 1, roll Doom Dice once, start of your turn. So You haven't got any XP or legend points, have you? So the Inquisitor won't be able to do his at start of turn ability. I'm just checking I've got everything. Start of turn stuff. My god, Jean de Meurs can... Wow, that's quite important. Right, anyway, let's go here with the Culverine. Okay?
Okay.
We're going to attack into the adjacent place. So I don't think you've got Retaliate with any of yours, have you? Sure. Defending, you might get legend points. That's the only thing with your heretics, but I'll take that. So, it's rolling three yellow dice for the Culverine. And my halberdiers are attacking with two white because you are foot units. Blanks on the yellow count as pushes. So, ready? Okay, so two shields on my white dice, which is pretty disappointing, but two pushes and a disrupt on the yellow.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm not gonna use my reroll token.
Okay, so I get to roll four dice in total, three black and one yellow, and the black's for the Flying Demons and the yellow's for the Heretics.
Sure.
And we managed to roll shields on all of the black dice.
So of course you do. It's going to be like this again, isn't it? Oh, where was your rally point? Where's your rally point? Oh, my word. So you basically get the perfect roll. Where's your rally point, Andrew?
Oh, good point. I will put the rally point with the devil.
Okay. Right, well, that was disappointing, wasn't it? Oh, that's really annoying. Right, okay. Let's go for the archers. So that's going to be four yellow dice. Same hex. I've got to try and break them up a little bit, make you use your resources. Oh, nice. Three pushes and a disrupt. Right, stop getting legend points. Stop getting legend points, you.
So here we go again, rolling exactly the same.
Yep.
And feeling very, very lucky. Here we go.
Yeah, it won't happen twice. Or it will. It hasn't done it. Oh, you're kidding me.
So we have two shields and another blank. So
two pushes.
We'll take another token.
So two pushes go through. So who would you like me to push?
You push the two of the Flying Demons. You can push.
Okay, so one's going to go to one's going to go south. One's going to go north.
Okay.
Okay.
So that did disrupt my plans quite a lot.
Yeah, but it's. I was hoping for a bit more, to be honest, but never mind. Right. So what I might actually do... Now you've shown your hand a little bit, is... Can I move over walls?
Can you move over walls?
Yeah. You can't you? You just can't follow up.
Yeah, is that? I thought that was stakes that you could move through and you couldn't follow up.
I think, isn't it both? Walls. When defending, when cannot follow up after combat. Yeah, no, you can still walk past them.
Okay.
So with that in mind, I'm going to take my. I'm going to spend an action up. You see up the this building on the left?
Yeah.
No, that's probably not a good idea. Actually. No, actually. Inquisitor, Inquisitor's area at the ruins is going to go next. Okay.
Yes, I've got you.
Yep. And they're going to move one space up to this small house here.
Yeah.
And then I'm going to activate that area and move them one space. Oh no, what am I talking about? Sorry, forget that. That was, no, that's not what I wanted to do. Sorry. I want them to stay there. I'm going to use the large house at the top. I'm going to activate the large house at the top to move the foot knights out. And then I'm going to activate that area to move them into the area with the well.
Into the area with the well. Okie dokie, I see what you're doing.
So I'm just going to just make you have lots of options. But that could,
thank you very much. That could
backfire quite easily. But we'll see. And I think that'll do for me. So I'm going to recover my cubes. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4. And over to you, sir.
Okay. So what I want to try and do is regroup the areas that you pushed away, and then go on the offensive against the Culverin and the Halberdiers.
Yeah.
I think first of all, what I want to do is activate my Devil. Devil has this uber command.
It is, yeah. It's stupid not to command use his command.
So what I will do is activate the Devil, and then I get to command 5 units that are 5 away.
That's great.
So what we're going to first of all do, what we're first of all going to do is command the Heretics and the
Flying Demons.
Flying Demons to attack into that area. Let's just see what happens.
Oh, you're going to attack? Okay. So that's a black.
So we're attacking with a black, a yellow, and a
yellow. Okay. I'm not sure on the rules for war machines about hit points. Do they change that?
Sorry, I don't know.
All right, well, I'll have to read that when we come to it. All right. So I've got a black, a red, and a white. The red and white have got retaliation.
Could be bad.
All right.
Rolling now for the attack. And we have 2 push and a
D. Do you want to re-roll?
No, I'm happy with that. We'll disrupt and push you if we can.
Okay, so I've got a shield and then a kill and a push. So I get rid of the disrupt, but you will be pushing me, but then you will... You will apply a kill and a push to yours.
Yes. So we will kill the demon, the flying demons.
Okay, that gives me 2 XP, but obviously I think they just go into the infirmary, is that correct?
Yeah, I believe so.
I think that's what...
And then where do you want to push the heretics?
We'll push it. Push them south, I guess. That's further than anywhere else.
Okay.
And then both of mine get pushed. Is that correct?
Yeah, right. Uh-huh. So I just really wanted to get them out of the area with the shrine.
We're gonna need to read about war machines, I'm afraid, because again, I don't know about pushing.
Okay. I'm gonna push. Oh, right. Okay.
I don't see why not, but sorry, I should know this. War machines. Two are turning into base size 1. Those machines can only retrieve units with the crew skill. Okay, so that's not going to be much use. Okay, it doesn't say. No, you can push them. You can only push them 1, so that's fine.
Okay.
Okay, so where are you going to push which unit? Andrew? just connecting up again. While we wait.
I don't know what's happening with the connection.
Okay. So where are they getting pushed to?
I'm going to push the Culverine and the Halberdiers, both of them southeast.
Like this? Oh, southeast, sorry. Like this.
Yeah, southeast.
Okay.
The video picture's gone really bad on my end now. Got loads of lines across.
Oh dear. Okay. Do you wanna update your board as well? Doing the same. Perfect.
I've done that. The quality of the camera feed that I'm getting now is quite bad, but we'll try and continue.
Okay. All right. So that's two. That's two.
I've still got some command.
Yeah, you still got three left.
That's two of the commands. Yeah, so I'm going to command all of the units up here, two Demonic Legions and the Walls,
yep.
Into 12B.
Okay, straight east then, yeah?
Yeah, and then the Devil himself.
Yep.
The Devil himself is going to move forward and destroy the tree.
Okay, so bye-bye tree. Hello, Devil.
Boom.
Oh dear. That was one cube. I might interrupt. Wait. I might interrupt. Now, let's just have a little look at the Devil's defense. Two automatic blocks, and it can't be pushed. I've not exactly got a lot of stuff to use. So the best way is to try and... you know what? I am going to interrupt. I'm going to use my blue interrupt. And I'm going to place it...
Okay.
I'm going to place it here. And I'm going to move these two units back to the shrine.
Okay. Sorry, Tom. We're going to have to restart the video call because... See, there's black lines.
Yep, no worries. Just restart. So we're just getting FaceTime back up again. Oh, so good. So epic, this game. We're okay again. Is that any better?
I can see more at the moment than you are, which is lovely. But I can't see
the board. Oh yeah, sorry. I need to flip that. There you go.
That's okay. That's it. Awesome. So who are you activating?
I activate the Culverine and the Halberdiers and move them back into the shrine.
Cheeky.
Right. Yeah.
Okay. I do quite like that play. I must admit that is quite good.
I'm really after those resources because my Inquisitor can change legend points to intrigue, and I really need intrigue. Because
yeah.
Archangel Gabriel is an absolute beast. Interesting. No. Okay, so you can carry on. I presume with the Devil.
The devil is going to activate again.
Yep.
Those flying demons can actually attack from where they are.
Yeah, they've got a shoot of one, haven't they?
Yeah.
They do.
All together. I will do that for one of the command abilities. I will actually first of all, I'm going to command all three of those up here, the Wolf and the Demonic Legions,
yep.
To attack 9B. No, they can't attack because you're still in the house.
Yeah, no, you can't. They can't actually attack the house. They can't damage the house.
Yeah. Okay, so what we're going to do then is the original plan. So this set of flying demons are just going to have a little pop into that area.
So one so flying demon. Yep.
Okay.
Into where? Into the culverin?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Obviously, retaliation won't trigger. So I'm just looking.
One disrupt and one blank.
I got the shield, but I believe you get a legend point again.
Yeah.
Oh my god, have you read? I presume you've read What the Devil Can Do, right? His bottom
action.
No, the one below that. Yeah, well, you might want to read that.
Oh, wow.
He's...
Okay, yeah, that's pretty legit.
Yeah, that's pretty bad. To take one of my units. Now, it says units, so you can actually technically take over characters then.
So if I attack you...
Oh, no, sorry. Troop. Enemy troop. Enemy troop.
Yeah, enemy troop. Yeah. So I'd have to attack you. You'd have to defend and roll a black shield. Is that right?
No. You spend a legend point. You roll the black dice. Enemy troop of your choice moves into an adjacent allied area and becomes unholy under your control. So basically, the troop's got to be near you so that you can go, and you've got to control the area that the troop goes into. But if you meet all those requisitions, then yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Bro, bro, bro.
So, anyway, let's go and see how we get on. So, that was the first command, was the flying demons there. Those flying demons are now going to have another go.
Are they going to pop the same people?
Yeah.
Okay.
And we've got a disrupt and a push this time.
And I got a shield. So the push goes through. They haven't got targeting erosion, have they? No. Alright, which one's going to be... Oh, sorry. Push the culverin.
Okay,
No, don't push the culverin, push the halberdiers.
Okay, let's go back southeast.
Okay. Yep. Okay, and so you've still got three left.
Yeah, three left. So, simply just going to bring these guys up here. All of those are going to move down. They're going to start coming into the...
Okay, so just moving one down. The wall, just remember the walls have got haste, I believe. I might be wrong.
Well, they have haste too, don't they? Yeah, so they could jog on. Yes, so we will let them jog on one more spot. They'll leave the demonic legion behind and they'll charge on.
Okay, if you can just point your screen on them, just so I can make sure I've got it right. Yep, that's fine. Yep.
Great. And then it's quite tempting to go for a gigantic attack of the devil into the area of the ruin.
Yeah.
So I get to roll two dice.
That's correct.
Two gigantic dice, but I have to assign one dice to each area.
That's right.
And given that there's nothing in the other area, I'm just going to roll the one gigantic dice.
But because it's the devil, you roll an extra gigantic dice.
Yeah, so each time the devil performs a gigantic attack, it rolls an extra gigantic attack and allocates each result to the area of your choice.
Yeah, so you roll you roll three.
Yeah.
You roll three dice and you allocate two of them.
Why three?
Because there's two areas. Are you attacking the ruins?
Yeah.
Yeah, so there's two areas in the ruin.
Oh, per area in Tiger Hang, sorry, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so trample, and push.
Okay, so the trample is much better than push, so. Because with trample, the ruins will get destroyed. The trample
right.
Forces, is that right? Forces a push. So I can't defend against it, if I remember rightly.
Okay.
So I think that's why trample's much better than push. I will double check
okay, so there's
the rules.
So when it's time for the lightning?
Yeah, automatic push.
Okay.
With no defense roll.
So
the ruin's destroyed, and I have to push these two guys, so.
Do they both get pushed, do they?
They both get pushed, yeah. Oh, you decide where they get pushed, by the way. So church or large house or bowman area.
I can still push them here, like, couldn't I, closer to the devil?
No, because the devil's going into that hex.
Oh, of course, yes. We'll put them into the church then.
What, both of them?
Yeah.
Okay. And on comes the devil. Hang on,
this big beast of a devil stomps forward again.
It is ridiculous. I don't know what the rule is on command in terms of, like you did it all in one you did it all in one phase, right? Before your activation, are you allowed to split up your command points between the start and end of your activation? So like, do two commands, have your turn, and then do three. I don't think you can you? You've got to do either before or.
I don't think so. Or I think commands like a bonus action. So you have to use the bonus action. It just so happens that the beast is a mighty thing.
Yeah. Alright, cool.
So, yeah. So, I think I will then, since you're talking about it, use this once per turn legendary and steal one of your bowmen.
Oh, you're going to take one of my bowmen? Well, you're going to try anyway.
So I'm going to spend, I've got three legendary points at the moment, so I'm going to spend one of the legendary points.
Okay.
And I'm going to roll a black dice, try and get a steal. If I do, I steal one of your bowmen.
Okay, go on then.
Is that right?
That is correct. No. You wouldn't quite be able to do it. Because if you read it, enemy troop... Well, no, it says enemy moves into an adjacent allied area. So it has to go to an adjacent allied area, and there is no adjacent allied area for you.
Okay.
So an allied area is where you've got troops. So basically, you've got to move the targeted unit into an area with your troops, and then you can turn them.
Sure. But I don't even have to be anywhere near your...
No, that's true, that's true. So...
halberdiers, and then if I did manage to command them, they could go in with the heretics.
That's correct, yeah. Yeah, you could go with the halberdiers,
so
yeah.
So I'm going to go for the halberdiers with this legendary.
Right, okay.
And I'm now rolling the die, a shield, and then I get to steal your halberdiers.
That'd be horrendous.
So here we go. Oh, it's a disrupt. It's kind of a... Yeah,
it's more. Is that a cocked dice?
It's landed in the form. It was a disrupt.
I suppose that was a right. Technically, that's a cocked dice, and in gaming, you get to re-roll it.
I'll re-roll it then. Sorry.
If it's a cocked dice, then just roll it. Re-roll it.
Okay. Here we go.
That is an official rule.
Oh, you might regret that.
It's only fair. Right. So the halberdiers. I'm going to take the white base off them. I'm just going to put the phone down a second. And then, oh no, they're not mine. Okay, so the white base has gone off the halberdiers. They moved in to the heretics area.
Yeah.
No, do you have the card to hand for halberdiers?
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, because I pulled out all the cards for you, so that I knew. So that's good.
Okay, right. Well, at least you can't do that again.
I just have to keep activating this devil.
Oh, yeah.
It's so obscene.
Yeah.
So,
you could
activate the devil one more time.
Yeah, it makes sense.
To try and get those away from the shrine.
Oh yeah, I got you. So
this is a red and a yellow.
Okay, so just one black dice now, with just the Culverin.
I got a push and a kill.
Oh my word. I didn't get shield. Which means that one of these units is killed, which means I think I can't use the Culverin again. And one of them, I believe that's how it works, because I need crewmen to be able to use it.
Yeah.
So it's still a unit. All right, it gets, so you kill off, I don't think you get XP for units, I'll just check. Oh no! Yeah, you've not destroyed the unit yet, so you don't quite get the XP yet. Where do you want to push the Culverin to?
Units.
Okay, all right, so that's one.
But I'll try and ding him again with the other flying demons that are to the north of him.
Okay.
And that's two disrupts.
Oh, it's disrupted, I'm at what I roll. So that is now disrupted, I believe that's how it works.
Okay. Right, and then we will... command the demonic legions and wolves up here.
Yep.
And we're going to command them east because we're going to go and try and potentially fight this worm.
Yeah, that makes sense. Okay, so they've gone over to there. Right, what's your devil doing?
The devil is going to go for another gigantic attack. It's just a case of whether or not he wants to go. Well, he's got a pretty interesting choice here. I think I want to go into the area to the east of the devil.
Well, with the bowman.
With the small house. With the small house in.
So the small house has.
The rationale being is that I'll get an extra gigantic dice.
Yes.
That's a two.
Just to point out, the house has a resistance of two. So you won't be able to kind of follow up into there, but you certainly can attack it.
Yeah.
So
it's just got like a resistance to fire, hasn't it?
What it has?
Church.
So the church has got a resistance of three normally, but I've got a character in there making it a four. So four, two, and two. Big houses, small houses, resistance of two. So you're doing a gigantic attack, yeah?
Okay. Gigantic attack on the small house to the east, okay?
Right, three dice.
Well, we got rid of those first. And here we go. Okay, so we've managed to get two kills and a tramp.
So they all do damage to the house. What do you want to go for? Do you want to go for two kill results onto the area? Or do you want to push them out of the way?
I think I want to do two kills.
Okay.
And then put the trample there.
Right.
And I'll just take out both the bowmen.
Okay, cool. So I put a rubble token onto the building. And because you've damaged a building, I now have to reveal this token in this small house, and it's blank. The Pope is not in the small house. And now I need to defend against these two kill results. So I'm rolling two white dice.
Yep.
And, Was it stakes that give them double up their defense? It was, wasn't it?
Yeah, I believe so, yeah.
Right, here we go. I get one shield. So one is killed. You get one XP.
Yeah. Okay.
For that. Oops. And I think that's that activation. Now, the good news is you can't activate the devil again because you are stuck in that.
Yeah, that's right. I can't follow up, so I can't activate.
Oh, at last.
I've only got one activation left as well. So what I am going to do is attack the well with the two demonic legions and the wolf.
Okay. So I've got my retaliation with foot knights of a black blood. Okay, yep.
So we have two white and two yellow for both of the wolves. One yellow and one white for the wolves, and then two whites for the demonic legions. So we are good to go. Right, you ready?
We're probably going to be playing at 1 o'clock in the morning, you realise that?
Yeah, three white.
Okay.
And completely useless apart from one disrupt.
I might defend this. So I've got one black dice to defend. I don't defend, I get a disrupt. So that's actually retaliated. I cancelled a push, you didn't get any pushes, did you?
No.
So I'm disrupted. But you have to apply a disrupt to you as well.
Okay, so I will get rid of one of the demonic legions.
Are they immortal as well?
No, they're not.
Okay. I presume you're going to follow up. Oh, you did follow up.
The end of... I have followed up, yeah.
Yeah, I thought so. Is that the end of your turn?
Yes, that was fun.
Oh, well, not really. Not for me, it wasn't.
I'm sure I didn't even play that optimally. It's the first time playing with these gigantic creatures.
I don't know. I mean, the devil is all about the converting and his command. His command is so, so strong.
Yes.
Just remember, he's also got targeting, which I completely forgot about, which means when you do an attack, you decide where the attack dice are allocated, not me.
Okay, yeah, that makes sense.
So he's, he's pretty awesome.
I don't know about, his standard attack's only two red dice.
And an automatic kill. Which is quite nice. All right, let's go to the infirmary then. So let's go for my culverine first of all, because I don't really care about this. Now, just to point out, once per round, I can re-roll the doom dice once. So I'm not going to do it on this one. just because I can't use it, it's dead, by the way. I got a death. So that's dead, you get another XP. Right, this is the important one, my foot knights. Dead, I'm gonna use my ability on Philip de Victory to re-roll that. And dead again.
Jesus.
Oh my word, another victory point. Not victory point. XP. Is it XP? I hope I'm getting that right, not legend points. Sorry, legend points, not XP. You get legend points, not XP.
Right.
So I think you should have three legend points. Is that right?
And the footnotes.
Yep.
And there's already, I was at three and then I used one, so now I'm at four.
Okay, cool. Wow. Okay, your turn. Doom dice.
Yeah, I need to find the doom dice.
I'll roll it for you. I'm doing really good with my rolls.
There it is. I've got my doom dice. So I've got some flying demons and a demonic legion. So first of all, for flying demons.
Okay.
they're dead.
Okay, so again, don't die, but I get XP. They can never die.
Yeah, they're immortal. They never die. And then the demonic legions, these don't have immortal, so I need to roll nicely with these. And I didn't.
Wow! As well. Wow, so they're dead.
I should have asked you to roll the doom dice, Tom.
That is nuts! That was death all around, wasn't it?
It was.
I wouldn't have got the 2 XP again for the flying demon, so I just get 1 XP for the legion, which gives me a 3 XP in total. Okay. Right, so next round.
So, yeah, but I think, do I get anything for the well?
Oh, that's... Oh, good point. No, there's War Council. Start of the War Council. Oh, man. That's so annoying. I've got nothing. Right, anyway. Got 3 activations.
Okay.
Now we do it. Because it's the start of the War Council. You get either an intrigue or a legend point. Your choice.
I'll take the intrigue.
I'll just check that. I believe that's so. Where did it say that? Beginning of the war, each war council, 1 or 1. What did you go for? Intrigue?
An intrigue, mate, yeah.
What are yours like? Oh my word.
Have you got the card there, have you?
Yeah, it's not phenomenal, yours, to be fair, but. Oh, wow. That's really cool. Okay. War Council. So, either spend one of your activations to gain 3 XP or 3 legend points. Heal 1 or charge. And that's the same. Or change one of your activations to a charge. So, get rid of one of your orders for 3 XP or 3 legend points. Remove a wound or gain a charge or change a order into a charge. So the third one's pointless as we've got out of charge. I don't know. I really don't know. Brutal. I think I need to get legend points so I can start gaining some intrigue slowly but surely. Okay. Yeah, which might sound a bit bizarre, but I'm going to get rid of one of my orders and gain 3 legend points.
Okay.
What do you want?
I'm going to take the charge.
Okay. Awesome. Right. So I'm going to use the Inquisitor's ability, which is at the start of my turn. I roll a black dice. On a result of a shield, I get to steal one of your XP or legend points. I see. So.
Okay, I don't have any XP points, but I do have legend.
It's the legend I want. But lo and behold, no shield, obviously. Oh dear. I know, this is disappointing. Right, so it makes sense for the Inquisitor. Yeah. But the Inquisitor doesn't have any attack. This is so bad.
Sorry, Tom. Start the second round, you get some...
Oh, wow! I was thinking, I'm a bit defeated here. Thank you very much. I should have 3 units from available Italian units in one area edge of the board, and that's my choice. So I think we're going to get the knights in. Oh, right. This would have been at the start of the round, right? I'm going to do a take back if that's
it. Yeah, does it make a difference?
It does, because I want to get my Mounted Knights in and charge. So I'm going to get...
I'm with you.
Yeah, so I'm going to get my order back with a charge cube, and I'm going to take away those legend points. Okay? Sorry.
Okay.
Sorry, because I didn't realise.
No, that's absolutely fine. No problem.
Then we're going to go over right at the top. I think it's 1A, the yellow field.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to place the two mounted knights. And I think... where are my cards for them? Yeah. I think we're going to... We might bring out the main guy as well. Oh, no. Not... No, forget that. Do they all have to go in the same area? One area at the edge of the game board. So I'm going to bring in the standard bearer. Just because it's so strong, the standard bearer.
Okay.
I really want him into the...
So standard bearer and two mounted knights.
That's correct. Alright, so let's put them down there. Okay, right. Cool. I've done the Inquisitor's thing anyway. So that makes a bit more sense. So you haven't got an interrupt at the moment, have you?
No, but I will just warn you that the devil does have a special rule. As the devil always has a special rule.
Of course he does.
At any time, I can spend two of my normal orders to gain...
Okay, so I basically at the end of each of my activations, I'll just say, do you want to interrupt? Okay?
Sure.
So, charge cube into the top area where I've just brought those people in. The knights will obviously charge and attack, and the standard bearer will just move up. So all three units are moving towards, and we're going to attack with four red dice. I get to attack! With something that's not terrible.
Yeah, that does look pretty legit.
Okay. And we get two kills, two disrupts. Oh, it's a good roll. Yeah, last.
That's impressive against my three yellow dice. So things are going to move.
Three yellow. You have got dodge. You need to roll the wall set. Well, don't mind.
Oh, sorry. Roll the
It actually doesn't matter. You didn't get a blank. You didn't get a blank, so it doesn't matter.
Okay, so I think it was two shields and a blank, wasn't it?
Two shields and a push. You got.
No. Two shields and a push.
So the two shields get rid of the kills.
So basically, those two guys are disrupted.
Those two guys are disrupted, yeah. And I will follow up, but I can only follow up with just the mounted knights, not the standard bearer.
That's right. The standard bearer stays behind.
Because he didn't attack. Right, do you want to interrupt?
No, I don't.
Okay. Cool. That was quite cool.
Bringing those knights in. Getting to choose their deployment, and charging was a good option there.
Right, so the cool thing is, am I judging? Just thinking, looking at the board. Yeah, I think I'm going to do this. So, I'm going to put an activation into the standard bearer's area. Yep.
Okay.
The mounted knights are going to go into the church area. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Or is it 7? The size is 2 for the church, so yeah. We're on 6 inside the middle area. And the standard bearer will just move up one space to the well.
Okay, can you just show me that a bit closer, Tom, so I can just catch exactly what happened there?
Yeah, so do you know the standard... The standard bearer has moved up one.
Towards the knights.
Yeah, and the two knights have gone into the church area.
Why have two knights moved?
Because the standard bearer has a 3 units one away, I believe.
Doesn't it? Oh, right, okay, sorry, I thought that...
He has a command ability. Oh, hang on. One unit. Sorry, can I move you one unit? You can only move one unit.
Yeah, that's right. So one unit goes into the church area.
That's correct.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so just to recap, in that church area, you've got the Inquisitor.
Yep.
The Executioner.
Yep.
One set of lights.
Yep.
The church and your deployment area.
That's correct. And my rally point, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you want to interrupt?
I don't know, it's really tempting to go and try and attack that church now that you put those knights in there. So, yes, I am going to do the craziness. I'm going to take two of my grand activations, and I'm going to get an interrupt.
Okay.
And I'm going to find the interrupt to activate the devil.
Ooh, okay. Okay.
So this is majorly scuppering and hounding my turn. next turn. But I feel I kind of need to start to close in and put some pressure on you now. Because at the beginning of your third round, you place all the remaining battalion units on the board.
That's correct. Yeah, I get everyone else back onto the board.
So the start of the next turn is going to be try and get some of my guys.
Oh, sorry. I should have also received an extra activation order.
Yeah.
Sorry, go on. So, what, are you attacking in there, or what are you going to do?
First of all, I'm going to use that command ability.
Oh, you can't. It's not. You can't do a command. It's not a grey cube.
Oh, sorry. Yeah. No, I can't. So, yeah. Attack the church area with the gigantic dice.
You're going for gigantic, okay. So it's two dice. There's three units. There's basically three units in there. So let's say you get a kill result. That'd be three kill results going through that I have to defend against. Okay, so I presume going for the kill.
So we'll pop the kill.
I can reroll one dice because it's got a building when defending. So three kill results going through from you. I defend with the Inquisitor defends with a black, the horses defend with a black, and the Executioner defends with a white. Oof, this could be quite brutal. Oh man, it's a kill push. What? All right. I think I'm gonna be using my reroll token for that. So I'm spending my reroll token.
Okay. Good luck.
Two shields. So one kill goes through. The Inquisitor does have 2 hit points. So yeah, I'm just gonna take one wound on the Inquisitor. No, but he made me use my reroll token. Oh, and one damage onto the church.
Yeah. And
it has
to reveal now.
I have to reveal now. So that's resistance 3-4. The church is blank.
Ooh, okay. So that was quite costly. That did cause me to spend two activations, and my turn is now depleted. But on to you.
Yep, right. So with that all in mind, we need to do something with command. So I'm going to activate the, how many have we got? Three. One, two. Yeah. I'm going to activate the church. Okay.
Okay.
I'm going to move the two units out. I think I can. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yep, I can. So the two units, is it Gendarmer and the Foot Knights come out? Yep.
In the church, I've got halberdiers.
Sorry, they are halberdiers, sorry. Yeah, the halberdiers.
Okay.
Then, you can't interrupt me again, can you?
No. I've only got one grey and one green.
So then I'm going to move all of those units into the large house area. So you should have the large house with, which should have still characters in it. Yes, it does. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4. We've got two characters, the halberdiers, executioner, and the knights. Yeah?
Yeah.
I mean, I think I'd do an attack, I think. We could build a barricade, actually. However, I've never done so many of these things. Do you know how to build a barricade?
No, this is awesome.
Because Philip, no. Jean de Meuse has got engineering. Barricade. Place a barricade in the same area unit as performing the action. This can be performed for a interior area or in anything built or in an area containing a building. And it takes up one space in the area. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, which is exactly right for that area as well. Gives an extra white dice in defense and prevents you following up. Yeah, let's do it. I've never done a barricade before. So, I'm going to activate...
Thanks for telling me where the Pope is.
What do you mean? Well, no.
You
need to know the
big house.
Well, yeah, but...
Now you're building a barricade.
But I'm building a barricade. I'm going to make it as hard as possible. And to be fair, you've got nothing over that side. And I'm going to you know where all the reinforcements are going. I might be right. I might be right here.
Well, if you're
bluffing
me, I can always go for
the experiment. Yeah, of course. I need a barricade token now. So I'm just trying to look for a barricade token. There. Yeah, the first ever barricade I've made in this area. So it actually goes in the area itself.
Okay.
And then I'm going to put... I'm going to heal... Oh no, he's in the building itself, isn't he? So he can't do... I think I'm just going to attack with the others.
Okay.
I'm going to... The Inquisitor will pray for his action. Oh, or should I put him in the building? No, he's going to pray for an action to get a legend token. Okay, so that's what the Inquisitor's done. Then I'm going to attack with everyone else. So, it's two red dice for the knights. It's one white. I presume he's not infantry. One white. Is that all he's got for the halberdiers? Well, okay. Yellow for the executioner. Man, it's not that great, is it? Oh, well. Yeah, so two red, a yellow, and a white.
Okay.
I might be able to get something on you. First of all, you got to roll your terror. So it's two dice, two black dice. This could be... Yeah. Oh, well. Any shields? One shield. So, one of my... So, I'm going to have to take away one of my red dice. Oh, really? Yeah. No, you know what? I'm just going to stop. Or do I just get rid of the white dice? I'm actually going to get rid of the white dice because I kind of need kills or disrupts. I need kills or disrupts. So I think my red dice have better odds. All right?
Yeah.
This is going to be really, really hard because you've got two automatic blocks. Unfortunately, the yellow dice did not give me what I wanted. I wanted a blank, really. I can re-roll it. I'm going to do it. I'm going to spend a legend token to re-roll the yellow. Actually, it's the only point to do 1 point of damage. Nah, forget it. That just wanted to attack the devil once. I'm afraid that is it. Yeah, that's me done. So.
Did you store your animations?
Yep. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That was basically five activations in total I had.
Wow.
Yeah, I know. All right, over to you.
Okay, so that church is still pretty tough, right?
Yeah, church is, well, it's lost one, so it's got two left.
House that's barricaded, surrounded by a wall, and all that good stuff. This is really all about the devil, and I'm gonna have.
How many have you got? Two? Have you got two? One activation?
I've got one standard and one charge.
And one charge, okay.
So I can't command. Charge.
You can't.
Command with the original
ray. That's correct.
Ray action.
Oh, put me my own.
So the way I'm set up at the moment, my non-devil troops are pretty useless. They're all a long way away from the action. I'm just checking whether I've got anything that I can use around this intrigue. Could draw two legend cards, but they're not legend points, so the chances of that. Okay, well, we're going to basically put the grey cube on the devil, as you would expect.
I'm going to start bringing
things into play.
So, what are you doing?
So, I've activated the devil with the grey activation cube.
Sure.
And we're using the devil's command ability.
Yep.
First of all, this area over here, these wolves are both going to go with the hate and move down to here.
Yep.
And the flying demons are going to also move into the same area.
Okay.
So that's moved two of them. And then I'm going to take the heretics and the flying demons southwest.
Okay.
And then I think.
Can you just show me your screen of those of where they've ended up? Yep.
This is the flying demons and the heretics.
Yep.
And then this is your area here.
Yep. I've got that. And then the wolves and the flying demon above next to the wall. Yep.
So there's the shrine. And and the other flying demon.
Okay, yep, got that. Right, what's your devil doing?
The devil, better the devil you know. he's going to do a standard attack.
On what? On the large house area?
Yeah, I think that's all you can do. We're gonna do a gigantic attack, of course.
Really? I suppose so, actually, because it's quite a few units. Oh yeah.
Yeah.
I forgot about. Yeah. All right.
I'm just gonna roll.
Oh, this could be brutal.
To trample.
Oh, you didn't get the kill. You didn't get the kill. Thank God. However, what? They're all going to get pushed.
Wait, because I think...
Reroll?
I think this is the timed reroll token.
There he goes. Go on then.
So, we're going to reroll both of these.
Yeah. Oh. Two tramples. Come on. Two pushes.
Oh.
What have you got? Oh, you got a kill.
A kill and a push.
So, kill. 5 kills. And another destruction on the building. So, let's put the thingy. First of all, I need to reveal the token, which is blank. But I've got to defend this huge 6-kill attack. Right, so, horses, halberdiers, executioner's white, then the characters, a black for the Mer, and a black for the Inquisitor. Oh man, 6 dice defense. Oh, this is going to be... Oh man, I've got no hit points. This could be brutal. Oh, that's good. Oh, no, it's not. Only 2 shields. 4 kill results go through. Wow. So, the horses, the halberdiers, and the executioner all die. Oh, this is brutal. Because you get a fair amount of legend points for my characters. One of them's dead. Jindamer is dead. So you get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 legend points.
Okay.
Oh my word, that was brutal. But that's another turn. I got to survive 6 turns. This is not going to happen.
Well, you're going to get all those coming in
now. I know. All right, you got a charge cube, right?
I've got a charge cube, but I can't reactivate the devil because there's no chance of following up.
Nope.
But I will try and nab another one of your units. No, I can't. Ah, that's a shame.
Why can't you?
Because I don't have any of your troops that are within an area of my troops.
The bowmen. Oh, no, not no, the bowmen aren't either. Yeah, no, yeah, you're right. No, you're right, yeah. Area. Yeah. Remember, you can, even though you know he's there now, you can spend one legendary point if you're in the area with the building.
Yeah, I did think about that, because I can get the wolves there. I can activate that area with the wolves.
Yeah.
The wolves can haste on to the area. I don't think there's an awful lot of benefit to doing that.
Oh, sorry, the barricade. I'm going to roll another white dice for defence for the barricade.
Oh, sorry, yes.
Which I didn't get a shield for, so don't worry about it.
Okay. Tricky. What are we going to do? I think the smart move here is just to save that cube. And then Yeah, I'm gonna save the cube.
Yeah.
So there we go. Doom dice time.
Yeah, okay, and turn. So they're all yours. So
yeah. So we'll go for the wolves first. They go to the waiting area.
Okay.
Next up is the Demonic Legion. They also go to the waiting area.
Okay.
And finally, the flying immortal demon.
Which don't seem to die. Of course, you get that on there. Oh, brilliant.
So unfortunately, I don't get anything back. But yeah, turn card.
Right, so first of all, I've got to put my units. So two areas on the game board. So you guessed it, where they're going, aren't you?
yeah.
Right at the top. So my Pavaseers are really good for defense. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4. Oops. 5. Six. Oh, actually, six. So I'm basically placing everything remaining, apart from the two mounted archers, in the forest area.
Yeah.
Just north of the whatever it's called.
Okay. So we've got two powers of ears, two crossbowmen, the standard bearer. Oh, no, sorry, the musician, and your hero. Okay. And
okay.
Where are the two mounted?
They are going to go. They are going to go here. So basically, trapping your demonic legion.
Yeah, I've got you.
Okay.
No, but yeah.
Right. I need to sort my area out a little bit. So the Inquisitor's still alive. He's gone. The Executioner's gone. The Culverine's gone. Have I got any more foot knights? Yes, I've got a foot knight over there and I've got a halberdier. So I still need those. Right, let's put the new guys down. Okay, that's a little bit better. Okay, five activations.
Five activations and just one clarification. Yep. In the large house,
yeah,
is John Demers and Halbier still inside that building?
John Demers is dead. Philip de Vitry and the Halberdiers are still in that building, yes.
Okay, I took the wrong dude off, so that was good that I. Oh no, I haven't. No, Philip, yeah, sorry. Yeah.
Yeah?
That's Philip.
Okie dokie, let's.
Yeah, sorry. Right.
Ready for the war council?
Okay, so. Grabbing my five activation cubes.
Sure.
Five. You gotta deal with five devils, dude.
Yeah, I know.
Potentially.
Well, you're a bit trapped there, to be honest. Ish. Anyway.
No, because I'm just going up to the spirit in the skies.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, of course. Right. So move one of your rally points to any one and rally one allied unit. Oh, Jesus. Or gain a charge. Same thing again. So gain a charge or remove a wound or discard a legend card to gain 2 XP or 2 legend points. So. I seem to have a lot of orders.
Yep.
So to be honest, don't know. The big house only has a resistance of 2. So that big house is not good. Oh, that's really not good. I'm gonna get them out. That's for sure. I don't know. I'm thinking of moving my rally point in a way. I think it's quite strong. Either or just healing up the Inquisitor one. You know what? I'm gonna heal the Inquisitor. One hit point.
Okay.
What are you gonna do?
I'll take it. There's a charge, wasn't
there? There's a charge, yeah.
Yeah, I'll take the charge.
Yeah, fair enough. So you got 5 grey and a green, yeah? And
two
greens. Two greens, yeah.
Yeah.
Right, okay, start my turn. Let's see if I can steal some of your legend points. I get the shield. So I'll take one of your legend points.
Okay. Chuck one away.
Right, I have two. So I could gain one. Now, what is my play here? I think I have to just move my bulk down a little bit, I think. And just get them to attack, I feel. Yeah, I don't think I'm going to get the intrigue quite yet. Oh, sorry, I've got one of those areas, so I actually can. I'm going to grab one intrigue for the well area.
Oh, of course, yeah.
Cool. Then, right. So then I'm going to spend two to grab another intrigue.
I'm
gonna try. I'm a bit off at the moment. Okay, then we're gonna spend our first activation in the new forest area.
Yeah.
The first action will actually be to command the two mounted bowmen to attack your demonic legion. Yeah. To attack your two Benomic Raven, which is I can't even speak, which is these two black dice.
Okay.
And that's two disrupts.
Okay, two yellow dice in defense. A push and a blank, so the blank gets me another legend point. Oh, I need it.
And they're disrupted.
And they are disrupted.
Cool. And then who's going to move in? Let me have a little look a minute. Pavasir's may reroll one. Pavasir's is so strong for defense. So, oops. I'm going to move the two Pavasir's into the large house area. I'm going to move. How far's crossbowman can shoot one. So I think it'll be able to hit much there. Oh my word. Musician's going in. The leader's going in. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And that's my capacity. So they are now at capacity. And my crossbowmen are going to move into the same area as the mounted bowmen. So,
crossbowmen in the mount. Yeah, I've got
yep.
you. Yeah.
Okay, so that's looking like a really nice defensive bubble now. Like that. For good old Popey. You know what? I might reveal Pope. Oh my God! I'm revealing Pope. I've just read what he does. So I reveal the Pope. I could do it any time. Which brings the Pope on. And he says, I can once per turn, I can spend 1 XP to gain 1 legend point. So I'm going to be doing that. 1 XP, another legend.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, one away. Oh, this is looking quite good for me now. With my amazing deception. Do you wish to interrupt? Oh, hold on, the musician can... Oh my lord, the musician can also command up to 3 hexes away. 1, 2... Yeah!
Can I do a gigantic attack from the sky on any area?
You might need to read the rule, but I don't know. I think it's classed as adjacent. I think so, yes. I believe you can do, yeah. I'm gonna order... Yeah, I'm going to order my bowman to shoot with my musician, okay?
Just 1 second. I'm just wondering about reacting and putting the devil in the sky.
Oh, well, I've got to finish off my activation first.
Okay, yeah.
So this is still part of the same activation. So the bowmen are going to shoot at your... Probably the heretics, yeah. They're going to shoot... It might give you some more legend points, but hey-ho. Yeah, they're going to shoot these guys.
Okay.
So your flying demons and heretics with shields turn to disrupt. 2 disrupts.
Oh, that is good. Oh, sorry, I was removing those dice from the tray.
Yeah, of course.
Just 1 shield. So,
1 disrupt.
I think the heretics have been disrupted.
Okay. Then they're going to place stakes down on the boundary between the devil and them.
Okay.
Right. So, you want to find out about... Did you find out?
Once on the next turn, and what I was thinking about trying to do was putting the devil in the sky, and then I wanted to see if I could do a gigantic attack from the sky.
Okay, so if you go to sky,
it's also a flying unit, it can perform its gigantic attack from a sky hex to any ground hex.
I thought so, yeah.
Yes, I'm going to interrupt.
Okay.
I'm going to... two of my normal activations to get an interrupt.
Yep.
And I'm going to put the devil in the sky.
Okay, which
decided.
Where in the sky? On the 3 or the single?
Oh, sorry, I've got them both as...
Sorry, I should have shown you, shouldn't I? I've got the 3 area and the single.
I've got them set up based on the printed copy.
Yeah, but you randomly draw them.
Ah, okay. There's... So I think we just have different stuff then. I'll put them into the one with the 1 hex, because if you end up putting the angel into the 3, then I'll get a bonus on my gigantic attack on that. So I'll go into the 1 hex area.
Fair enough. Okay. Yep.
We might need to restart the audio again. It's the video even. It's gone black lines across it again.
Yeah, sure. If you want to hang up and then call again.
Yes, it is. So, just to recap, devil's up in the sky. We know the bishop's down there. And I have used my activation. So, all I've got left... It's
not
bad.
Okay. Yep. So is that 3 grey and 2 green?
Yeah, that's right. I've got 3 grey and 2 green left.
Right. So my second activation. I suppose if we're gonna have any chance to do this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is interesting. What to do? All right, I'm gonna actually activate my crossbowman and my mounted bowman. Okay.
Okay.
My mounted bowmen are both going to go down to just normal bowmen.
Yeah.
Which I didn't think of, so I only have one bowman unit. that's annoying. I'll just use the culverine just for now. Is that
right? Sure.
Is that right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Just so, just because I'm not going to go into my core box and try and find everything. And we're going to shoot the devil with all of those units. So that's 4 yellow dice and 2 red dice.
Okay.
Ooh, hang on. Wait. We're also going to change them to entrenched crossbowmen to add another 2 white dice to that attack pool. So the crossbowmen are attacking with a white and red each, and the bowmen with yellow dice. Yellow dice, obviously, shields go up. Okay, ready? So 2 pushes, blank doesn't do anything. Oh, this is not a great roll. Oh, that's a terrible roll. Basically, he doesn't get pushed. So nothing happens. That's an awful roll. No, you got 2 automatic blocks and you cancel all pushes.
Oh, it cancels all pushes.
Oh yeah, you can't use push results.
I just interpret that as cancelling one push. Okay.
No, I believe that's cancel all push. You can't be pushed, so you ignore all push results.
Automatically, that makes sense.
Yeah, that might not be right. Do you want to interrupt?
Yes, I do.
So you're taking your 2.
This is where I now activations.
Yeah.
But I'm going to interrupt.
Yep.
And the interrupt is going to be for a gigantic area attack on the Pope.
Okay. I'm all right with that.
Are you?
I think so, because if you push me, I'll just push back in. If you kill me, I've got a hell of a lot of defense. I should be all right. I mean, it's still going to do 1 damage to the building. But, you know.
Okay, so we have disrupt, a kill, and a push.
Presume you're going for the kill?
Yeah, absolutely.
So that's 1 damage onto the building. And then it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 kill results going through. But now, wait, watch this for a defense. So.
So I can assign another dice as well, can't I, to that area?
Well, you know, you assign a dice to each area, but there's nothing in the other area.
It says allocate each result to the area of your choice until all areas of trample hex can have 1 result.
Yeah. So basically, you're not using 1 of your dice. So the area. So you put for each area of the hex, you allocate 1 of your trample dice, one of your gigantic dice. Sorry.
Yes. So the kill would go here.
Yep.
The push would go there, and the disrupt would go there.
No. You're not going to use 1 of your dice because you won't. If you read the card. It says until have 1 result, not 2.
Oh, okay.
Does that make sense? So basically, you're increasing your odds of getting a dice you want
yep.
with a devil.
Yeah, that makes sense, yeah.
Okay, so 4 kills going through. We've got my main guy who rolls two yellow, and any blanks are counted as shields. My Pavaseers are defending with a yellow and black each. A white and a black each. And they can give a different unit a reroll of one dice. The musician is rolling a white dice. But then the musician adds one white dice to defense of all units in the area. So that's going to be another three white dice. And I can reroll up to two of these dice. Okay?
Wow, that's quite impressive. Go
on then. Oh, crumbs! This was the devil attacking, wasn't it? The musician's actually got Terror 1. Believe or not. Oh my word, that is horrendous. One shield on a white die, on a yellow dice. I can't believe that is amazing attack. I'm going to re-roll two of the black dice, obviously.
Okay.
I had to get another shield, but that's only two shields. Oh my word. How did that happen? Two kills go through. So I take one wound on my hero, and I'm going to have to kill off. Oh, so disappointing.
The bishop.
Pavaseers, I guess. Gain a legend point. Shocking rolling. That's disappointing. Okay. But the good news is your devil is still not up to much at the minute. Then we're going to activate... Okay, let's just bolster that up again, I think. You can't interrupt again, can you?
No, I cannot interrupt again. All right.
Okay. Oh, I'm activating... Hang on, let me think this through a second. If I activate them, they can come out.
Oh, actually, I wonder if I can interrupt again if I wanted to, because I could use a charge cube as a standard cube, right?
Not for this action. It has to be a grey cube.
Has to be two grey ones. Okay. Yeah.
So, one, two, three. One, two, three. Yeah, I think this works. I'm going to put my next activation in the large house on the left, you know, with Philip de Vitry.
Yeah.
And bring them both out.
Okay.
The halberdiers and Vitry. Okay, that's fine. The next one's going to be in that area.
Yes.
And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yep. Then they're going to move the two characters and the halberdiers into the well area.
Okay.
And then my final action is to activate the well area. And I'm going to move the standard bearer 100%. Although, he's perhaps not as strong. Philip de Vitry is definitely going in there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, that's it, actually, isn't it?
That's a big house.
Yep, so that takes a 2, does it? Size 2.
Yeah.
3, 4, 5, 6, that's it. Just Philip de Vitry, which means I will take a legend point from the Inquisitor praying. I think that's it. Yeah, I'm happy with that. And that is my go.
Yeah, okay. So, my turn.
Well, unless I can command someone. Has anyone got command? Yes, they do. Oh, I might as well use their command, sorry. So I've got Standard Bearer's command, basically, which is going to be one unit, which is going to be my entrenched crossbowmen, which are going to shoot at the halberdiers that you stole off me.
OK. Okay.
Attacking with a red and a white. Getting a two disrupts.
And defending with a red and a white, but the retaliation doesn't work.
No.
One shield.
So, disrupted. Nice, that's, yeah, that's better. Okay, that's me done. Take away all my cubes. Oh, shit. Okay. Yeah, I might have screwed up there a little bit, but let's go with it.
Not sure. yeah, I really don't have many other options other than to use my last remaining lucky grey cube.
Yeah.
Activate the devil.
Yep.
That's a standard action. I can use the command ability.
Yeah.
So I will command the wolves and the
flying.
The flying demons to ping in an attack there. We'll just let them, we'll command them into that area so that they're coming up to the church.
Oh, yeah. Are you sure? What happens with the gigantic attack in that case?
Oh, that's a really good point, yeah. I probably best to do the, I'll do that first actually.
Right, yeah.
Gigantic attack first and then do the command, you're right.
Makes sense. Now what I forgot about was the fact that now I should be alright defending this, but you're gonna destroy the house and I'm gonna take undefended a red dice, I believe, on the Pope.
On the Pope, yeah.
So it's pretty much guaranteed wound. It's not the end of the world, but it was a bit of a disaster. Alright.
Yeah.
Go on and roll your three dice. There's a trample.
And a trample.
If you did want to push me out of the way.
No, I think.
Or four kill results going through.
With the kill.
Right, okay, so four kill results going through. I'm not going to roll as badly as I did last time. So.
And the building's destroyed, yeah?
The building's destroyed. So I do have a little. Destroyed ruins there, I can put on there.
Oh, that was very organized.
Well, it's in the kit, isn't it? I'll roll the red dice anyway. Do I roll the red dice to see if he, or do you roll it?
I don't know, buddy. You roll it, it doesn't matter, does it, really?
He gets the wound.
Okay.
So the Pope's taken a wound, that's not good. Right, so I need to defend. So my leader is, or the character is two yellow, the Pavasir's is a white and a black, Philip de Vitry's is a yellow and a black, the musician is a white, and then we have one, two, three more white dice, with only one reroll this time.
The dice is basically better this time.
No, I hope so. It's quite hard to roll these. I'm going to roll half at a time because. No. Oh, that changes into a shield because of his ability, but none on those. And then one more shield. So only one shield. Oh, the yellow dice changes into a shield. And then I'm going to reroll a black and a white. Ah, he gets it. There's the four shields.
Nice.
So just.
Nice.
My white dice does not give me shields at all. All right. So just about survived. What do you want to do for your command?
I just realised actually I'm not going to take it back, but I think I would be better off
Where's the
using the charge cube to bring the devil down. So, right, what we're going to do with our command, really, we haven't got many troops left.
Is it ruins? Just a question, is it ruins count as one or none? In terms of capacity? Yeah, I'm not sure. Size one, thank you. Okay, so that's fine then. I've got six in there now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, so we're okay. Okay.
Right. I don't like the fact that you can ping my devil with all your flying dudes because I'm in the sky, but I can't do anything about that. I will command these into here.
Next to the area.
Yeah.
Okay, you still got two more.
I've still got two green activations, and I've still got two more command. I may as well command these flying demons to start heading towards the Pope for what it's worth. So they just moved up one.
Yeah.
And just to use the last one, I'll move one of these wolves.
Two spaces.
So they've gone up into. So one set of wolves is in EA.
Yep. Eight A.
Yeah, it's getting late.
It is.
And then, I think I'm just going to have a punt at this. I mean, you've got so much defence there that this is very unlikely to work.
I don't think I've got any retaliation, though.
I'm going to activate this area up here with one of my green.
Sure.
And attack. So we've got two wolves.
I need to roll those separately. I've got Terra 1, but you've got Terra, haven't you?
No, not on the wolves and the flying demons.
I have to roll a black dice. I do get shield, so one of your choice. You basically don't attack with them. Oh, actually, what do they attack with? Basically, just get rid of one yellow dice.
Yeah.
Okay.
Makes sense.
Right, okay.
So, this isn't really
going to Philip the Victory. Other guy. Standard Bearer.
Pope.
Pope.
I've got two pushes and two disrupts.
Yeah, I've got a hell of a lot going on a minute. And then four more white dice. Oh my god! That is a powerhouse I'm defending with. This is all my dice I'm defending with. I will roll these two yellows separately because they're the ones that blanks give me shields. Are you there, mate?
Yeah, still here.
All right, correct. So let's do those two first. So these are ones where blanks turn to shields. No blanks, so that's nothing. I can re-roll and then rest them. So how many shields do I need?
Well, I've got two push and two disrupt.
Okay, so I do need to reroll one of them. So let's reroll the black. No, one goes through, so a push?
Yeah.
They haven't got targeting, have they?
No, they haven't, no. The only thing that mine's got targeting is the devil, and that's probably why I should have brought the devil down.
Ah, right, yeah. You can push. Interesting.
I can push the Pope, right?
No. Push. This character here, Rienzi.
Okay, I will. I'll push him north.
Okay, cool. I
could go. Northwest.
Yep. All right.
And having failed with that, I'm going to save the last charge cube because I'm thinking I'm going to have to use a few for my devil next turn.
Cool.
So that's the end of my turn.
Okay, so your demons and your wolves get rallied, first of all.
Yep.
And it's up to you, the order you want to do with the rest of them.
Yep. 1 second, just... too many things on the table now.
It is pretty mental, isn't it?
What I'm doing is I know I had my rally point where the devil was. I was just checking which of these two hectares it was. Okay, so it's the furthest one, actually.
It is. It's the one on the edge. It's the one on the edge.
Yeah. So that's right. So I've got the wolves and the demonics there.
Yeah.
Now I've got my dream dice and I've got four units to rally.
You do.
So I'm going to try and rally your halberdiers first.
Okay. Kill.
Yeah.
Yay! 1 XP.
And next, the Heretics. The Heretics Rally.
Heretics Rally? Oh, okay.
Demonic Legions.
Yep.
They're waiting.
Yep. And the ever present.
The flying demons, which have been dead the whole game.
It's going to happen again, isn't it? Oh, they're never going to get out of there, they are. Superb.
No, that's it. Right, okay.
All right. So, start round. We don't have to worry about anything now. So, let's go straight into...
I get a legend point for the shrine.
Yeah, it's cubes first. So, it's four activations. Okay. Four activations this time.
Four?
Yep. I'll also gain a legend point for controlling the well. Oh, yeah. You know he's coming in, don't you?
Yeah, unfortunately.
Amazeballs. Right, okay, anyway. Let's see what the War Council's going to be like. I'll tell you what, when those reinforcements come in, my word. I suppose that's the aim of the game, isn't it? Is to try and take out the Pope before reinforcements come in. Right. Oh man, this is an amazing war council. Interrupt, reactivation, I know what you're going for, or normal order. I'm going to go for, interesting. I actually think, interrupt might be better than the reactivation for me. Yeah. I'm going to get an interrupt. I presume you're getting a reactivation.
No, I'm going to get an interrupt as well.
Oh, I suppose it saves you two. Yeah. Good point. I don't mind, just keep getting cubes. Right, okay, cool. So, right, start a turn, roll a black dice. Let's see if I steal... I do. Can I take one of your legend points? You got a legend point, haven't you?
Yeah, I've got loads, yeah.
Yeah, I'll take one of them, please. Thank you. Then I'm going to spend an XP to get intrigue with my poop, which gives me my four intrigue, if I can get it. And I'm going to immediately spend that to, it says, place Archangel Gabriel in a free sky area or in Pope's area. And there is one space left for Pope. So Archangel Gabriel is going in the same area as the Pope.
Wow.
Oh, yeah. I've done it now.
You can take it back and put it somewhere else if you want.
No. You know when I grabbed a legend point instead of an XP?
Okay.
For a thingy? Can I take that back and grab an XP instead?
Yeah.
You sure?
Yeah, totally.
Thanks, because I'd rather level up people than... I don't need legend points anymore, necessarily. I could get one intrigue, but I can't put a barricade in that area. I'll give him terror 2, which would be really useful. Okay, so you got an interrupt. Well, you potentially got a few interrupts, haven't you?
Yeah, potentially.
Okay. Right. So, let's try and clear that area first. Although you can't... Well, you could bring the devil down and just do something. Let's start off... Eeny, meeny, miny, mo. I think I've got enough defense in that area to be good. I think I need to maneuver... that lot. Yeah. This is hard to know what to do. He's immune to push. That's really annoying that he's immune to push. That makes it so much harder for the archers to do something. Oh God. I just realised bowmen, they're not that great, are they?
No, they're not
A
that
one
good.
in three chance of doing a hit, not phenomenal. Or do I just shoot at your at those guys? That might be better actually. Or do I just literally attack you? I can pray, I can heal, but I'll be attacking with just Archangel Gabriel with that bunch. Yeah, not. Then. I don't like where that's going. This is really hard. I'm not gonna lie, I'm actually quite worried about your devil. Obviously. All right, we're gonna activate this area here. With the bowman and the crossbowman. I'm going to put stakes down in front of them.
Okay.
And we're going to shoot into this area here, I think. Yeah. So red, yeah. Shall I go for you? Could just start to take down the devil. That it should be no. I've got to go for the sensible option. Get rid of your units. So yeah, we're aiming into this area here and try and take out your units.
Okay. So I
Let's
do have dodge.
oh, you do have dodge, okay, so blanks, you'll be able to dodge out the way. So that's a kill, three disrupts, because that says to disrupt, and a push.
I think I'm rolling in vain, but I'm rolling my two wolves. And yeah, they didn't get anything exciting.
No.
And so I'd be as well roll the flying demon's defensive blanks.
Oh dear.
Yeah.
Right. So one kill. One kill, two disrupts.
One of the wolves is dead, and then the other two are disrupted.
Sure. So I get one XP for that. That's good. I want XP. Want to level up. What happens to Pope Clement? I need to start leveling up some people. Well, four. Okay, we're getting there. I've shot. Do you want to interrupt?
Yes, I do want to interrupt.
Okay, so just using your interrupt, I presume.
Yeah, and I'm going to bring the devil
Yeah.
down. But where can I put the devil? Because there's a tree there, and I can't just
It,
land on
yeah,
the
you can,
tree.
you can. New rules. You can land on anywhere that's not a building. And destroy the terrain.
Oh, okay. In that case, then, yeah,
At the
rather
back.
less. Do I want to come down there? Yeah, I think so. I think I've just got to go for it now. My only option is to kill the Pope. I have hardly any other troops that are active, so we're gonna come down to where that tree is,
Yep.
right next to the church.
So destroy the tree. Next to the church.
Next to the large house where the
Yeah.
Pope is.
Yeah.
Sorry,
That's
I'm getting
okay.
tired.
That's right, mate.
I've also bizarrely been bitten and my arm is reacting to something.
Oh, mate, that's not good. What, literally in the house?
I don't know.
going to move the church so I can see a little bit more. All right. So that was that. So it's back to me. Right. Interesting. I just read what he's got. So if I keep him behind and the standard bearer, should I take the standard bearer with me? I'm going to activate the well area.
Okay.
And we're going to just move everyone up one. Okay. Everyone up one space. Okay. Oh, hang on. Wait. Oh, no. Yeah, no. That makes complete sense. The standard bearer could get someone to do something up to 3 hexes away. So yeah, so one of the entrenched crossbowmen are going to shoot at your flying demons on the shrine. Okay?
Yep.
A kill and a disrupt.
Okay, so I will roll the dice just because it makes a difference if I get a shield. And I do get a shield, so the disrupt is not killed.
Okay. And I believe the Inquisitor can't. Nope. That's it. Do you want to interrupt?
Yes, I do.
Okay. So are you spending 2 cubes to get one?
Yeah, I will be. I'm just. See, the thing is. Yeah, I am going to. I'm trying to convince myself this is the right plan.
Just remember, if you the blue cubes, the interrupts go away at the end of my turn.
Oh, that's interesting. I thought all the cubes stayed on the board until the.
No, at the end of each player's turn, they get, that's the beauty of interrupts.
Ah. Okay, that's fine then. So I will do it. So I'll use 2 cubes, take an interrupt, and I'll activate the devil.
Okay.
We still have one more turn after this, don't we?
Two more. It's only the fourth round, so we've still got 2 more rounds.
Right, okay. So what I'm actually going to do here is a gigantic attack, but on the bowman and the crossbowman.
Oh, you go for it.
Okay.
All right.
So that will leave me with a charge and 2 standard activations.
And 2 standard activations. Okay. So 3 dice.
Yep. So just clearing out the dice tray. Important throws coming up here. Right, here we go.
Oh. That'll be a trample. However. That is a, just let you know, they're entrenched crossbowmen. So if they're ever pushed, they're destroyed instead.
Oh, right, okay. I haven't actually got the entrenched crossbowmen.
So you will kill both crossbowmen.
Oh, well, that's good then.
So I presume you want to go trample. You haven't got a reroll anyway, have you?
No, I haven't got a reroll, no.
So 2 more legend points. 2 more legend points.
Yeah.
And where do you want to move my... Oh, you've only got one place you can put my bowman, which is north. Because you're going into that hex.
Yeah, absolutely. That's correct, yeah.
So I'll get rid of my stakes and I'll move you into here.
Yes.
Okay.
Interrupt done.
You can't interrupt again, can you?
I can because I've still got two.
Oh, you still got
two actions and a charge.
Okay.
But I don't think I will.
No.
Because I won't have anything left for my turn then. I just wanted to take out those bowmen before they started firing.
No, fair enough. I'm going to activate this area with the Pope. Philip de Vitry is going to heal the Pope one, so he's back to full health.
Okay.
I think... yeah. I'm going to level up the Pope now. Is that okay? I think I can do that, right?
Yes.
Right. It costs 3 to level up. And when he's leveled up, the reason why I'm doing it is because, if I just show you, he units in the same area as Pope the Sixth can never change factions or be controlled by another player.
Okay.
I just want to take that away from you. He can control two units, one away. So I think he's going to control the mounted knights. Perhaps I should have gone that way. Yeah, no. The mounted knights and the halberdiers to go up with the Colel de Renzo.
Sorry, the mounted knights and the who, sorry?
And the halberdiers from the okay. Inquisitors area into that one.
Yeah.
The Pope will pray to get an XP.
Okay.
What else? I think that's it. I don't think I want to do anything with Archangel Gabriel. I've just seen something. He's got carrier, hasn't he?
Sorry, say that again?
He's got carrier if he's leveled up, which means he can carry the Pope away.
Well, you might want to do that as well, because most devils got targeting.
Yeah, I do have bodyguard. But yeah, that's true. Remember, you can't assign more than one dice to... potentially, it depends on how many dice you roll, to be fair. But you have to assign a dice to each unit, yeah?
Yeah.
So you can't put, like, 3 kills on the Pope, is what I'm trying to say.
Yeah.
I really don't know. I seem like I'm wasting Archangel Gabriel. No, I'm happy with him just there for now. Right, that's their turn done. Do you want to do anything?
No.
Okay, so... Yeah, I'm just going to activate the Inquisitor and the Standard Bearer, and they're literally just going to move up into the same area as the Mountain Knights. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 units in that area now.
Okay.
The Standard Bearer does have a 3 areas away. We've got 4 yellow dice. There's a chance, isn't there? You got Terror though, haven't you? Terror 2? Is it?
Yeah.
Alright,
Terror 2. Terror
2. Roll 2 black dice. I'm going to do it anyway, and there's nothing else to do.
So what are you doing? You attack him?
Oh no, hang on a minute. Yeah, I'm going to shoot you with my 2 archers. So roll 2
okay.
2 black dice, and let's see if I've got to get rid of some dice. Any shields? 1? So, 3 yellow dice. So, very unlikely that anything's going to happen from this. Oh, there's one off. 2 disrupts and a blank, which do nothing. Do I want to use my... I'll tell you what. I'm going to spend two legend tokens to get an intrigue. And then my Pope's going to use his ability to spend one intrigue to turn it into an XP.
Okay.
I need XP as much as possible.
Keep the Pope level.
Though. Right, my turn's done. Remove all the cubes.
Okay.
I think that's all of them. Right, over to you, sir.
Yeah, just thinking about the options here. Man, that area is so tough, isn't it? So tough.
Yeah.
So much defense in there.
It's got to withstand a fair amount of turns, but it should be okay, he says.
Yeah, I think you're probably going to be okay. I think I'm just going to have to go for that. So going to attack again on the area. I'm just wondering if it's worth trying to deplete some of your forces. We've got another turn.
Yeah.
I think
that's a hell of a lot of defense I've got in there now, though.
Yeah, it is. It is. What I'm going to do. This might seem a bit of a strange play. It probably is. But I'm going to put the Great Cube on the Devil,
yep.
And then I'll be able to use the Command ability.
Yep.
So we're going to try. I don't think we're really going to be able to get any of these guys into play, but we'll try. We need to try and start knocking out some of your stuff. So we're going to move the walls to 1-2.
Yep.
These walls to 1-2.
Yep.
The demonic legion and the heretics are going to move one, and then these wolves are going to move two as well. So they're going to move. So the wolves are joined up.
Yep.
Okay. The two wolves are joined up.
Yep.
And then what we're going to do with the devil is just literally move the devil.
Yep.
So that I can.
Where are you moving him? Sorry.
Activate.
Wait.
Sorry, I've moved the devil north.
Okay. I will interrupt.
Okay.
I'm going to interrupt with... Yes. I believe so. It is. It's only white. Standard Bearer does nothing. But he's got Slayer, which is quite cool. So that's going to be 1, 2, 3. There's a chance they can do something. So I'm going to activate the Mounted Knights area. Right, so
you're attacking the devil?
I haven't got any terror, so roll two dice. Black dice, sorry. So someone's gotta lose a dice. I think I'm gonna make the halberdiers lose their white dice. So basically I've got three red dice in attack, but the first red dice I've got, it's got Slayer. So if I manage to get a kill, it counts as two kills.
Okay.
All right, so I'm going to roll that first. And it doesn't do a kill. It's a push, so it does nothing. So it doesn't matter what I do. Two disrupts, get blocked. So that didn't work in the first time, but never mind. It was worth a go.
Okay.
And then I will use my Standard Bearer to... hold on. Adjacent 2. Unfortunately, there's no one in that adjacent 1 that can attack. So that's a bit pointless. Just shoot a bow. There's no target. No, there's no, literally nothing I can do there. That's fine. Got him.
Okay, so then I'm going to use another cube on the devil.
A grey one, I presume?
Another grey one, yeah. Sorry, I should have said.
That's fine.
And we're going to use the command ability again to try and get some stuff together. So the two wolves are going to move up to meet the other wolves.
Okay.
There's a pack of wolves coming after you.
Yeah.
I'd be as well try and get some of these guys up to the action, because the devil's maybe not going to be enough.
Yeah, that makes sense.
And then these guys here are both going to move into this area here.
Okay.
Okay. And then the devil is now going to do his... Who do we actually want to... Yeah. So... I want to take out that blinking standard bearer, so I'm going to do
an
attack with the devil. Yeah, but I'm going to use the targeting against the standard bearer.
Oh, I get you. All right, so just a normal attack, so that's one kill and two dice, is that right? Is that what you mean?
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. I do have terror. Oh, no, I don't. So that's a white. It's halberdier's white, red with retaliation. That's going to help. Black from that. Okay. Two yellows from that. Cancel to disrupt. And a black from that. So, the yellow dice... whoops. Just dropped my phone.
Oh dear.
That's all right. So, I'll roll my retaliation first, okay?
Yes.
Which is a disrupt and a push. Then I'm going to roll all the others. And I get two more shields. And no blanks on that, so that's that. So what did you get?
So I got a disrupt and a push, and then the automatic...
And a kill. So I get rid of the kill and disrupt. Kill and disrupt are gone. Oh, hang on.
Yes.
Actually, it's all gone, because my standard bearer cancels two disrupts. So the disrupt's gone.
Okay.
And then the two shields get rid of the thing. And then you take one wound from a retaliation.
Yeah, okay. And
he's bloodied.
It's my turn. I'm bloodied indeed. I'm saving the charge cube.
Right, okay. Right, you've got some guys to do stuff with.
Yeah, I do indeed. So the demonic legions are rallying.
Yep.
And then we've got flying demons. They're waiting.
Okay.
Finally. Second flying demons.
Yep.
They've rallied.
Okay.
Third flying demons. They've rallied.
Oh, wow. And?
And the wolves. The wolves are dead.
Ah, cool. That gives me an XP. Ooh, like me likes XP meters. Okay, that's that done, I believe. Okay, so fifth round is four activations.
Okay.
War Council.
I think we've built enough of a fort now that it's going to be pretty much impossible.
Oh, this is so good for me. Two legend points or two XP, three XP or an activation. I'm getting three XP without a shadow of a doubt. Which gives me a ton of XP, which is what I want. What do you want to go for?
Sorry, what were the options?
Two legend points, three XP or an activation. Grey activation.
Oh, I'll just take the activation.
Sure. Okay, let's see if I steal... Have you got any XP on you? Or just legend?
No, I haven't got any XP. I've got one intrigue and then a bunch of legendary.
So I'll take a legendary token from you.
Okay.
From my Inquisitor. That's quite funny. Start of turns. No, nothing else. Okay. Have you got any interrupts? Obviously, I meant base interrupts. You haven't, have you? You just got your grey cube.
No, I don't have any base interrupts. I've currently got five standard orders and one charge.
Right, so what's my player? How can I take you down? So I've got to pay one for Pope. I've got to pay one for the Pope for his upkeep. One XP for this Pope's upkeep.
Yeah.
I think we're going to level up.
All you've got to do is keep the Pope alive and you win.
Yeah, so I'm thinking... What's the score if someone's got terror? Does it just need terror to cancel the effects of terror? Do you remember?
Not to my knowledge. I think does terror only works in defence, doesn't it?
Right. Big immortal or terror of equal or superior value are immune to terror effects. Right. That's what I was wondering.
Okay.
So big immortal. Obviously your guy counts as that. So it's not going to matter. It's not going to matter. There's no point leveling Archangel Gabriel up, really. Oh, he gains an extra black in attack. That's quite good. Is it worth 4? Probably, yeah. I think I will. I'll spend the 4 XP to level up Archangel Gabriel. Gives him an extra dice in attack. And it gives him terror too, so he doesn't have to worry about... So if I attack you with him, it doesn't matter. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think... This is dodgy as hell. Oh, hang on though. Hang on. That could be quite funny. Sorry, I'm just checking up on a ruling or something, right? X areas. is that a better move? I don't know. And then you're gonna. So you could go. Yeah. And then you can order. I don't really want them attacking me, do I? Sorry, mate. I'm just. Oh! I think just get out there. Oh dear. Seems to have lost Andrew from the feed. Okay, so I'm really thinking about my options here of how best to tackle the way you're playing. It may seem a bit scabby, but I'm going to activate the area of the Pope. And now that Archangel Gabriel is now leveled up, he's going to carry the Pope 2 areas away. To go the one above the well. The one above the well.
With the yellow...
No, the area above the well.
Yeah.
So the stone bit.
Yeah, I'm with you.
There, you got it?
Yeah.
Then we're going to... I think I'll keep them there. Don't really want you moving. What else can these guys do? Heal. Not too fussed about. Yeah, I think what's going to happen, definitely, is these guys are all going to just move down one area. So the Pavasir, the musician, and, oh, not all of them. Sorry, not all of them. The musician. Yes, the musician will actually go up into this area. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah. The musician will go up and join with the knights and everyone else. Yeah?
I'm a bit confused because the knights were in the area with that now. Can you, is the video good enough for you to see what I've got here?
So that's the one above the... What is that one? Oh, that one. Okay, so, yeah. So you see that one there? Yeah, that one there. That one there. Did you move the musician up? So, in the one above... In the one above, you should...
Yeah, sorry. I'm with you.
Yeah, it should be 6 units. Yeah, that looks right. And then the Philip de Vitry and the Pavisiers have moved down one.
Okay.
That's it. Yep.
So you've left the big house empty.
I've left the house ruins. It's ruins, by the way. I've left that ruins empty. Yeah.
Okay, I'm with you now.
Yeah, I've left that area empty.
Cool.
Now I do have a one command I potentially use. The Pope, who hasn't been yet, is going to pray for an XP or legend point. And he'll command 2 units, one away. So he's going to command the horses. Hang on a minute. I need someone with terror. Oh no, it needs to be terror. Oh, yeah. It's a bit pointless, that. There's no point in them attacking. There's literally zero point in attacking. Because, oh, I suppose you might roll not shields on things. Yeah, I'll attack with the horses, and the only other one is the halberdiers.
Okay, horses and halberdiers attacking, so I'm going to roll for terror.
Yeah, 2 black dice.
And no shields.
Okay, there is a chance I can do 1 wound. Not with that roll. So nothing happens there. And I think that's it. 1, 2. Yeah. Yep. That'll do, I think. Pretty happy with that.
Okay, is that all
good? Yeah, I think so. I mean, I could move...
Do you have any
injury? Actually, no. I'll just move one Bowman unit. Sorry, the Bowman unit in the corner. I'm going to move one southwest. With my
okay.
With the musician's order.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. Do you want to interrupt?
No, I don't.
Okay. Next. This is so hard. I kind of want to just attack the devil, but that's a bit silly. Now, I don't have any interrupts, so you can send the devil up into the sky, you can bring him down, and then you can attack. So that could definitely happen.
It is going to happen.
So I need to plan for that. So... Do 2 units could be them and him. Go to there. That gives me that. Hmm. Yeah, I see. Yeah, that's a bit annoying. That could be quite funny. I'm tempted. This is so hard to know what to do. How many cubes have you got? Sorry.
I've got five and a green, so six in total.
Jeez, five and a green.
Five regular and one green.
Five regular and one green. I want to start.
Fancy my chances now.
Well, I perhaps shouldn't have moved them out. I perhaps should have just gone for it. Right. Sod it. Yeah, I'm a bit worried. I'm starting to get a bit worried. I'm activating this area here. The Pope is going to use his two to get these guys and then bring them into the Pope's area. So the standard bearer and the musician have moved from the command of the Pope to the Pope's area.
Okay.
The angel is moving into the vacated area, so next to the devil.
Okay.
Do you wish to interrupt?
No.
Okay. Next, activating the area with the angel. We're going to attack the devil. The Archangel Gabriel's got Terror 2, so you do not. So we're not afraid.
Okay.
And that's three red and a black for Archangel Gabriel. It's one red with Slayer for my main guy. Two red from the horse. And the halberdiers, I think, have only got one white dice. Well, this might do something. Right, Slayer first, okay? It's a push. Oh, dear. So it starts again. Hold on. Oh, no, I've moved the musician out. Was that a good idea? Oh, sorry, mate. The musician I leave in there. Is that okay? Can you hear me?
Okay. Yeah, sure.
Because what that does, it adds one white... One white dice to everyone. So that's attacking, obviously. So that's gonna be one for the horses, one for Gabriel, one for the other one. So let me just get it right. That was Slayer. I gotta roll this white dice, although it can't get Slayer, so don't worry about that. So horse, Gabriel, thingy, and three units. Okay, let's roll the rest. Let's hope we get some stuff. Oh, that's better. Two kills, two disrupts from that lot. Two kills and a disrupt from that. And the pushes are all cancelled. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 5 damage. Coming your way.
That puts the devil on 6 damage.
I didn't roll a shield, damn. And I didn't roll a shield. No, I didn't roll a shield, so I can't move the angel. Which is one of its abilities. Never mind. I'm okay with that, though, I think. That may have been a bad decision. Oh, dear. Oh, no. What have I just done? Oh, hold on. I know why I did this. Then we're going to move. Right, we're going to move. We need someone with the Inquisitor, I think it is. Yeah, it is the Inquisitor. The Inquisitor. I might have screwed this up a bit. Haven't I?
Yeah, you've left your Pope well.
Yeah, I've literally just realised that. I can spend an XP to get a with the Pope to get intrigue and immediately spend it to build a barricade. And I'm just going to use the one over here to put it in Pope's area.
Okay.
The Inquisitor is going to move to, yeah, to the area with the Pope and command the musician to come in with him. And then the others all attack, so I can't do anything with them. Oh dear. Oh dear. 3-1. Then the musician will command the pavisiers to just move, not in there, into the church. Oh dear, this has really not gone well. One, two, three, four, five. I kind of wanted, he's got the ability of, if I roll a shield, I can move after the attack. I was kind of relying on that, which perhaps wasn't the best plan. Yeah, the pavisiers will just move up one to the area just above again. Just
the ruins.
Yeah, just the ruins. The pavisiers, that is. Do you want to spend? Do you want to move one of your troops? No, I'm a little bit. Yeah, I'll spend one legend point to use Philip the Petri's thing, and I'm just gonna, all I'm gonna do is move one of your three wolves south of the church back one. And I think that's that activation over. Do you want to interrupt?
No, I'm good.
Oh dear. Yeah, I'm just gonna. This is pointless. Yeah, perhaps I should have prayed with the priest. I don't know, I would have been able to. That doesn't make a difference. Hey, dearie me, I'm a bit worried. okay, I'm going to activate the small house, the one that's left, and just bring that foot knight out with the bowman. Small house. Oh no. Go on then. Oh no, I might have just lost this, haven't I? Go on then.
Is it my turn?
It is.
Okay. So first of all, we're going to activate the devil.
Of course.
The devil's going to fly to
the sky. Okay, yep, of course.
Use the command ability of the devil.
Yep.
To move the two wolves.
Yep.
Through the church into the well.
Yep.
So that's two that have been commanded.
Yep.
We're going to move the heretics and the legions north.
Yep.
To the second half of 5-8.
Yep.
And we'll move the final wolves into the church.
Yep.
I will then spend a legend point to roll a black dice and attempt to recruit your standard bearer.
You can, because my Pope is stopping any units from his area.
Ah, okay. Yeah, I'm with you. In which case, I will take the, or try to take, I should say, the power viziers.
Yep.
So we're going to roll the black. We're looking for the shield.
Okay.
And we did not find it. We got a kill.
Okay.
Which would have been quite good. So that's all the commands done. So we will activate with another cube. The devil again.
Yep.
Yeah. you're having to bring the devil down into 1A.
Yep.
And we will also use the commands of that.
Yep.
So the wolves will attack the
area. The Palvises. Oh, the Palvises, okay.
Yeah, two wolves will attack the two Palvises. So that's yellow and a white, yellow and a white against the black and a white. Oh, when defending one unit in the same area. Okay, so there's no other area.
No.
Okay. So we've got two disrupts.
And I've got one shield, so they are disrupted.
Okay. And then for some further commands, we will command the heretics and the legions into 12B.
Yep.
And we'll just move the one of the flying demons north.
Okay. They got jumped too, haven't they? Yes.
Oh, yes, they do, actually, yeah. They can move north twice.
Yep.
Thank you. And then I will activate the devil again.
Yep.
And those flying demons will be commanded to jump to the heretics and the legions.
Yep.
And the, well, how much, you've got quite a lot of defense in there, haven't you? Probably not worth the dogs.
We've got some cancelling. We've also got terror.
Yeah, so I'll move with the, we're still with the command ability, I'll move the legions and the demonic flyers north one as well.
North one? Oh, have I put it in the wrong place?
For the devil.
Hang on, where are they now then?
So there's two lots that are right. So there's this lot here that moved up from the rally point. So there's the rally point they've moved.
Oh, sorry, those two. Sorry. Yeah. That's fine. Yeah.
And then the other dudes. There.
Yep, that's fine.
Right, so I think we are just going to have to do a my poor wolves. my poor wolves, if I do that. Do we go after the angel? There's one more turn left after this.
There is.
Okay. We have to do a gigantic attack on we're just going to go for the Pope. Right, gigantic attack on the Pope. The wolves are expendable.
Yeah, well, it depends what the dice is.
Oh, man. That is not that useful because...
Disrupts or trample, okay.
Yeah, I'm going to have to take the trample and disrupt my...
Really? You could just trample yours, which just means that you push them out of the way.